readings, right? So near point of convergence, also you need to repeat the test for 3 to 4 times and see whether the patient is not responding well, means the convergence is getting receded, that we need to see. Like some first time, suppose you have got a 7 centimeter NPC, second time we got a 8 centimeter, third time 8 centimeter, then 9 centimeter. If like this the NPC recedes, that means that may be a sign of a convergence insufficiency. Okay. Also, we discussed about the amplitude of accommodation. Amplitude of accommodation, you measure it with the RAF ruler. Okay. So you measure the amplitude of accommodation with the RAF ruler and correlate with the age. Okay. So with the help of Hofstadter's formula, you find it whether the accommodation is correlating with the age or not. Okay. So according to the the formula is 18.5 minus 0.3 into age. So if the suppose the age of the patient is 10 years, so 0.3 into age means 0.3 into 10, 3. So 18.5 minus 3, that means the 10-year-old child should have a 15.5 diopter of accommodation, right? So binocularly we check the accommodation, then we check the accommodation monocularly also. Okay. So suppose the accommodation is 15.5, it should be according to the age for a 10-year-old child. So suppose the accommodation the child is having around 13 diopter or a 14 diopter or a 12 diopter, that means there may be a chance of accommodation insufficiency. Also, sometimes we find that the binocular accommodation, whatever we are getting, like binocularly, whatever we have measured the accommodation, that is higher than the accommodation that we are getting monocularly. Suppose for the 10-year-old child, we are getting a 12 diopter of accommodation binocularly when measured. When he covers, we'll cover the left eye and then measure uniocularly also the accommodation. So suppose right eye we are getting a 11 diopter, left eye we are getting a 10 diopter, and binocular we are getting a 12 diopter. So this can be the case. Definitely it can happen, because in case of accommodation anomalies or accommodation insufficiency, so for this 10-year-old child, as a according to the age, by the Hofstadter's formula, what shall be the accommodation? It shall be around 15.5 diopter, right? So if the child is having 12 diopter, that means if the child is having 12 diopter accommodation, that means it may be a sign of accommodation insufficiency. Okay. So also we'll correlate with the monocular findings, but always do the binocular findings first and then we'll do the monocular findings. Is it clear to all of you? Any questions in this? Any questions? Okay. So also we have discussed about the push-up test for accommodation. Push-up test means you are keeping the reading book near to the patient and then you are pushing the, means you are bringing the near book towards the eyes of the patient and telling the patient that to mention the first sustained blur. Like when the first sustained blur occurs, that you are noting down. And then whatever you are getting, suppose you are getting a 10 centimeter, so you will measure it with this plastic scale you are having, that scale you have to measure like this from the canthus to the book, you will measure the distance at which the patient is getting the first sustained blur. So near vision book you are giving to the, you are bringing in front of the, keeping in front of the patient's eyes. Slowly, slowly you are moving it forward to the patient's eyes, right? At what point of time the letters are getting blurred? So first sustained blur you are noting down. First sustained blur means what we have discussed. First sustained blur means when the blur is there and the blur remains. Okay, the first blur noticed and it does not get cleared after blinking. Okay. So when the patient reports, suppose the patient reports blur. So you tell the patient blink and see whether it gets cleared. If it is getting cleared, means that is not the first sustained blur. So you can move it even forward. Okay. So you tell the patient to blink, and if it does not get clear, so you will move it forward. Like that is the first sustained blur. You will stop moving forward, and that is the first sustained blur. Means when the blur is noticed for the first time and it remains, the blur remains. That is the means the blur is sustained. So that is the first sustained blur, right? So first sustained blur when the patient is getting. So at that time you are stopping and you are measuring with the scale, so you will get the near point of accommodation from there. Okay, so this is a push-up test we have discussed, and N6 target, and we have no like getting in centimeter, we are getting the value in centimeter, and then we'll convert it into diopter. Okay, yes, any questions? Okay, so like then coming to negative lens of negative relative accommodation, I have discussed in the first in the class, previous class I have discussed. Yes, negative relative accommodation. Yes, so negative relative accommodation, what? Okay, what we are doing, negative relative accommodation, we are putting the plus lenses in 0.25 clicks. Okay, so you can see the patient is holding the reading book at his comfortable reading distance, and always be sure that the patient does not change the distance. So you will put the plus lenses in plus 0.25 clicks. Okay, so first you put the plus 0.25 lens in the trial frame. Then you take a plus 0.5 from the trial box, and then again you put it in the trial frame at the back side of the trial frame, and then you remove the plus 0.25 lenses. Okay, so this way you are adding the higher add lens, and then you are removing the lower lower power lens. Okay, and giving the patient NA target, and patient reports the first sustained blur. That means when the letters becomes blur, you stop it. So the value of NRA is around plus 2.5 diopters. That is a normal value of NRA that you should get. And positive relative accommodation means you are stimulating the accommodation. You are stimulating the accommodation means you are adding minus lenses in 0.25 clicks. Okay. And you are seeing till how much the patient can stimulate the accommodation. That means you are also noting here the first sustained blur, right? And you are noting down the value. So the PRA value, what we are getting, we are relating with the negative fusional value, negative fusional vergence value measured in the stave vergence test. Okay? So you will actually correlate, basically you will correlate the PRA value with the NFV value and also with the AC by A ratio. Okay? So like this, we will be correlating and finding out what shall be normal for the patient. So for PRA value, there is no normal value. Basically, we correlate with the negative fusional vergence value. So till this, we have discussed in the previous class. Also, I have discussed the dynamic retinoscopy. A normal lag of accommodation plus 0.5 to plus 0.75 is a normal lag of accommodation. What we should get in a dynamic retinoscopy, anything higher than plus 0.75 is a higher lag of accommodation. Anything lower than the plus 0.5 is a lead of accommodation. So that way we can find out. Okay. So the dynamic retinoscopy part is also completed. Now I will be coming to the accommodative facility testing. Accommodative facility testing. How it is done? Accommodative facility testing. Accommodative facility testing. So basically what we are recording, we are recording in cycles per minute, like how the patient can clear a plus lens as well as a minus lens. Okay. So we are recording it in a cycles per minute. Okay. So you can see the patient is holding a near vision book. Okay. So you can give an N6 target to the patient, right? You will keep your stopwatch. Nowadays in your mobile itself, you will get your stopwatch. So you can keep your stopwatch ready. So now you will be recording the number of cycles per minute the patient is able to clear in a minutes time. Okay, so how it is done, the accommodative flippers, how to select? You can select the value of accommodative flippers, like what, like will you take the flippers are in available in plus minus one. Okay, you can see this lens is over here, right? There are two lenses over here and two lenses above, right? So these two lenses are of plus value and two lenses are of minus value. So these are called accommodative flippers. So accommodative flippers basically are available in the market in plus minus one value, plus minus 1.5, plus minus 2. Like this, it is available in the market. Okay. So how to select, how much amount of accommodative flippers you should be selecting for the patient. Okay. So you can think, you can see the NRA and PRA value of the patient. So NRA and PRA value, basically you are measuring the, that is the accommodative response you are seeing. You are seeing how the NRA, by NRA you are seeing how much the patient can relax the accommodation to the maximum extent. Yes, how much maximum extent the patient can relax accommodation. And PRA, you can see how much maximum extent the patient can stimulate the accommodation, right? Also, we do the NRA test first and then we do the PRA test. Why? Because always in case of accommodation, we'll relax the accommodation first and then only you'll stimulate. Okay. Similarly, while doing your convergence test, you will diverge the eyes first and then you will do the convergence and all. Okay. So similarly, you will relax the accommodation and then you should stimulate the accommodation. That's why we do the NRA first and then the PRA test. Okay. So while doing the NRA test, you are putting those plus lenses and seeing the extreme limit till which the patient can accommodate, right? So you need to get back to the normal value also. Normal value means, so suppose you are getting a plus 0.25 in your NRA, right? So this plus 0.25, needs to be come back to zero. Then only you should start doing the PRA test. Why? Because you're relaxing the eyes, right? You're relaxing the accommodation and the accommodation is relaxed to the maximum extent. So if you do not bring the accommodation to the normal level, then otherwise you cannot do the PRA test. So NRA test, you are putting the, getting the maximum extent, you're slowly you are reducing the plus power and coming back to zero. Okay. Then give the patient 2 minutes time to adjust and then you start the PRA test, putting those minus lenses. Also after the PRA, suppose you are getting a minus 2 or a minus 3 in the PRA, so you should reduce the minus slowly in 0.5 steps and come back to zero. Otherwise the patient's accommodation will be highly stimulated and it will take much time for him to get back to the normal level, right? All these tests, after you do your NRA PRA test, right, you record the findings and then you start doing the accommodative facility testing. So how the accommodative facility testing is done? So normally this near vision book you can use definitely, and you choose the value of the flippers with the help of the NRA PRA test. So suppose in the NRA you have got a plus 2.5 and in the PRA you have got a minus 3. So also you can choose either plus minus 2 flipper or a plus minus 1.5 flipper. Because see, whatever is the NRA value, that means is the maximum maximum limit of accommodation, right? NRA value is the maximum limit of accommodation to be relaxed. So you cannot select any flipper's power that is greater than that. Otherwise, the patient will not be able to clear that, right? So that is the thing. Even for PRA also, the maximum extent to which the accommodation can be stimulated, you are measuring. So you cannot select any accommodative flipper power that will be greater than the PRA value. So always select at least a 0.5 lesser than whatever you're getting in the NRA PRA. So you can either select a plus minus 2 flipper or a plus minus 1.5 flipper here. Now you'll be recording the response. How? You can tell the patient to hold the near book at his reading distance. Okay. So 40 centimeter we are holding the book. The patient is holding the book. Now you are putting your mobile as a stopwatch. You are keeping it ready. And then what you will do, you will instruct the patient that first I will put these lenses in front of your eyes. The later you just give the patient the N6, any word to follow. Okay. So suppose in the N6 target, there is written various conditions may cause cataracts and all like that it is written. So tell the patient to focus on this various, suppose, okay, or conditions, any word, particular word you tell the patient to focus. And tell him that when you place these lenses in front of his eyes, the letters will get blurred at first. And then he has to blink and make them clear. Okay. So these instructions you have to give to the patients, and also the patient should not change the distance between the reading book and the eyes. Okay. He is holding it straight in front of his eyes, and the flippers, the patient will not be holding, you will be holding the flippers. Okay. The patient only holds the accommodative flippers while doing the exercise part. The exercise part we'll be discussing later on, but for the flippers test, you will be holding the flippers. The patient will be holding the reading book at 40 centimeter. Okay. So first, what we'll be doing? First, we'll be putting the plus lenses in the flippers. So when you see the flippers in like this, you can find out which is the plus lens and which side is the minus lens. Okay. So plus lenses should be used first. Why? Because always we relax the accommodation first, and then only we stimulate the accommodation. So always we have to start with the plus lenses. Okay. So you are keeping those plus lenses like this. You can see the patient is holding. So you will be holding the flippers. So you are keeping this plus lenses like this, and the letter will be, the word will get blurred. Okay. The patient will tell that blur. Tell him to blink and make it clear. Okay. Meanwhile, when you are keeping the flippers, you are starting the flippers test, you have put on your stopwatch. You have started your stopwatch. Okay. So one cycle is once the patient clears the plus lenses, and another time the patient clears the minus lenses. This complete is a one cycle. Okay. So you are keeping the plus lenses of the flippers in front of the patient's eyes. Patient will take some few seconds to clear the word, right? Tell the patient to blink and make it clear. Okay. So once the word becomes clear, the patient tells that clear, you flip the flippers. So once you flip the flippers, it's like we have seen a JCC, right? Your flipping means it is changing the cylinder. So here also, when you flip the flippers, so the plus lenses will the minus lenses will come in front of the eyes, right? So again, the patient will take some time, some few seconds time to clear the minus lenses, right? So this complete one cycle means you record it as one. So you count in your finger, and then again, when the patient clears the minus lens, again you flip it. So this way you continue the flippers test and record the readings. How many cycles per minute the patients complete in a 1 minute time? Okay. In 1 minute time, how many cycles the patients complete? That you are going to record in the accommodative facility testing with the help of accommodative flippers. Is it clear to all of you? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Any questions, anyone? Any questions?
Which letters we have to read in near vision chart? Which number? N8 or N6?
N6 you can give it. N6 will be fine. N6, any word you can give. Yes, Meena. N6 or N8? Yes. Yes, tell me.
We have to use rock cut chart or near vision chart, ma'am.
See, no, rock cut, what rock cut? You have seen what rock cut? Yes, what rock cut basically, sorry, not N6, N8 target you should give. Okay, sorry, I was wrong in that. So, rock cut, what rock cut you can see, there is like various words are there, right? So, this what rock cut basically, we give the patient to practice at home. So, when we are getting a like, the accommodative facility of the patient is low. Okay. So that time we give the exercises to the patient when the accommodation is low, accommodative facility is low. So this ward rock cut, basically we give it at the home to practice. So normally at the clinic when you are doing, you can use the ward rock cut or you can use the near vision N8 target. N8 target you give, tell the patient to focus on any ward, because in ward rock cut also you can see there are like around how many words, there are many words over there. So one day, each day you are telling the patient to clear one word like that, right? As an exercise you are giving. Okay. So,
okay. Ma'am, for accommodative facility, we give for near chart 20 by 40 or 20 by 50.
20 by 40, you can give it. Definitely you can give it. 20 by 40 you can give. So, yes, 20 by N8. Normally, if you are doing this near vision chart, this Jagger's chart, no, this one is having N8 targets, right? N8, N6, N10 targets and all, right? So, you give the N8 target in the near vision book. If we are using the word rock card, okay, that is the actual measure of the target, like what should be given for an exercise purpose at home. So you can use a ward rock card also. If you're using this Jagger's chart, you can give it, give this one. Any target you can give for measuring the flippers test, for doing the flippers test. Okay. And the flippers must be,
ma'am.
Okay. The flippers must be close to the eyes. You can see, okay, like a chashma, like a spectacle. It should like be close to the eyes, right? And you have to flip it. You have to flip it when the patient clears the lenses. Okay. Once the patient clears the lenses, you have to flip it. So one cycle completes means like plus lenses. Once the patient clears it, you will flip it and make it to the minus lenses. So the patient will again blink and clear this lenses. Okay. So one cycle, how many cycles a patient completes in a minute's time, that you are going to record in a accommodative flippers, the accommodative facility testing. Okay. Also, means there are some values. Okay. So in the Shiman and Wick book, I'll be sharing those values also. So, okay, there is showing that, okay, the meeting might end here. So you will again rejoin with the, it will end in 10 minutes. So please rejoin with the same link. Okay, please do rejoin with the same link. Okay, so for flippers, no, plus 1.5, there are some values, like around, suppose there are, it should be around 8 cycles per minute, the patient, that is a normal response. Suppose for plus minus 2, that is 4 to 5 cycles per minute, that is the normal response. Plus minus 1, that may be 10 to 12 cycles per minute, that may be the normal response. So always compare with the normal response. Means you have selected a plus minus 1.5 flipper. If the normal response for plus minus 1.5 is around 8 to 9 cycles per minute, see how many cycles per minute the patient is completing. If it is lesser, that means the patient might have the problem in accommodative facility. Is it clear? Similarly, if you are selecting the plus minus 2 flippers, compare with the gold standard one, means the normal values, that is for the plus minus 2 flippers that a normal patient should have. Is it clear? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, I have a question. Ma'am, yes. In some videos, it shows that we have to flip. We have to do this accommodative facility first in monocularly, then we have to do this in binocularly. So, ma'am, which method is convenient?
No, always do it binocularly first. Then only we'll do it monocularly. So always we do it binocularly. Also, while measuring the accommodation, amplitude of accommodation, you also remember that always we do it binocularly first, then we do the monocular response. Okay, because binocularly, when you are seeing your accommodation as well as your accommodative convergence is working. Okay, so basically, binocularly, when you are doing this accommodative facility listing, you might get a better response. Suppose a patient is having 10 cycles per minute binocularly when you are doing. So if you are doing it monocularly, it may be 8 cycles per minute. It might get reduced to 9 cycles per minute, or it may be 10 cycles. Okay, so always do binocularly and then only do it monocularly. For flippers also, first you will do it binocularly and then we will do the monocularly also we'll be doing, and similarly we'll keep a reading of that. Okay. Is it clear to all of you? Yes. Why? Because always binocularly your accommodative convergence as well as your accommodation both are acting. So basically you might get a better value. Okay. Suppose in binocularly you are getting 10 cycles per minute, and when you are doing it monocularly you are getting a drastic shift, like around 4 to 5 cycles per minute. Definitely you can understand that monocularly, see, we accommodate monocularly, right? Normally, we accommodate monocularly. So, that means if the monocular value is a drastic difference is there from the binocular value, that means the accommodation is definitely affected for the patient. So, the patient's binocular response is better than the much better than the monocular response, means the vergence is normal for the patient. Convergence, divergence, that is normal for the patient, but the patient is having some sort of accommodative dysfunctions. Always we have to correlate with the NRA PRA value. We have to correlate with the dynamic retinoscopy value. We have to correlate with the amplitude of accommodation value. Okay. So these way there are so many accommodation tests what we have discussed. So you can see this kind of flippers. Okay. So monocularly plus minus, okay. So there is a chart for this, how much amount of CPM the patient should cover up in, like in a single, for a single power, that we have to correlate, okay. So these are all the accommodative tests. Any queries do you have? Please do let me know. Any queries? Yes,
ma'am, can you repeat it? How will select the value of accommodative flipper according to NRA PRA?
See, if we are getting NRA value of plus 2.5 diopter and a PRA value of minus 2.5 diopter, suppose. So either we can select a plus minus 1.5 flipper or a plus minus 2 flipper. If the patient is facing some problem to clear the plus minus 2 flipper, you can go back to plus minus 1.5 flipper. This way, like the NRA PRA value, you are getting at least 0.5 lesser than the NRA PRA value you have to take. Then also sometimes we face difficulty. Suppose the NRA is plus 2.5, PRA is minus 2.5. We have started doing the flippers test with a plus minus 2. We will face problems. Sometimes the patient will not be able to clear the minus lens or a plus lens. Okay. So that time we can reduce it to 1.5 also. Is it clear, Choyam? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So for 1.5 flippers, maybe the it should be around 12 CPM per minute. Okay. Means 12 cycles per minute should be the value. So for plus minus 2, it may be 7 or 8 cycles per minute will be the value. So always correlate with this normal value. Means you have used a higher amount of power, that means the number of cycles will be lesser. Definitely, if you are using a higher amount of power in the flippers, the number of cycles will be lesser. So always correlate with the normal value of the flippers. Okay. So cycles per minute you are recording for the flippers, you are doing it binocularly, and then you are doing it monocularly and recording it, the flippers value. Okay. So all these things you can like either you can use a near vision chart or an accommodative rock chart for this. All these things will be correlating with each other and find it out what is the problem of the patient. Like these are the accommodative tests what I have discussed. Now I'll be discussing the Vargens test. So you have to find out where is the problem. Is the patient is having a accommodative dysfunction or the patient is having a Vargens dysfunction? That you are going to find out. Or there is a combination of both. That also may happen. If there is a combination of both. So that also, that is a fusional Vargens dysfunction that I'll be discussing later on. So where in fusional Vargens dysfunction, both accommodation and Vargens both are affected. Okay. So also another thing you need to note down while doing the flippers test. The patient, like which lens in a flipper, the patient is having difficulty to clear. Okay. Suppose with a plus minus 1.5 flipper you are doing, okay, the patient has run some 4 to 5 cycles. The patient will be particularly, you can see, the patient is having some difficulty to clear either the plus lenses or the minus lenses. That you have to note it down. The patient might find difficulty to clear either the plus lenses or the minus lenses. That you have to note it down. Or both also he can find it difficulty. So that also you have to note. Or if he fails to clear any plus lens or minus lens, that also you have to note it down. Suppose the patient is having difficulty to clear the plus lenses, that means he is unable to relax his accommodation to a normal level. Okay. If he's if the minus lenses, with the minus lenses the patient is having difficulty to clear with the clear the minus lenses, that means he cannot stimulate the accommodation to the normal level. Am I clear? Is it fine to all of you? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I'll be